started conjugate beam method. We have four steps. First step, if you remember, first step, we need to draw bending moment diagram with superposition. Draw bending moment diagram using superposition method. To remind you, superposition method means I would like to make my beam to be more simple. More simple. You cannot draw any moment with superposition if you still have bend connection. So please, if you have bend connection, please make your beam more simple by make separation. So I'm going to make separation. This part alone and this part alone. By the way, we have here at this fixed, we have three reactions, vertical, horizontal, and moment. At this location, we have one reaction, vertical reaction, because it's roller. This one is roller, this one is fixed. At your bend connection, we have horizontal reaction, vertical reaction. We have horizontal reaction, vertical reaction with the same values, but opposite direction. We have concentrated load here, 25 kilonewton. If you apply equilibrium equation, if you go back to chapter 2, summation f of x equals 0, summation f of y equals 0, summation moment at any point equals 0 for this part, the right bar, I can figure out the reactions. This reaction will be 12.5, and this horizontal reaction will be 0. This reaction will be the same values, but in opposite direction. If you apply here summation f of x equals 0, summation f of y equals 0, summation moment at any point equals 0, I can figure out this reaction 0, this reaction 12.5, and this moment will be 37.5. Then I will start to draw the bending moment diagram. After I did my beam more simple and I get my reaction. Your beam originally looks like this. Here is the roller. Here is the bend connection. Here is the fixed. Step by step. This part with reaction here. And the two reaction here and the one concentrated load at mid span looks like beam with roller and the hinge and the concentrated load. If you go back to these diagrams, if you have simply supported beam, hinge and roller, and one concentrated load, your bending moment diagram looks like triangle. This value of moment, PAB divide L. Okay? So, this distance 3, this distance 3, the total distance is 6. That means your bending moment diagram for this shape will be triangle. The vertex of this triangle will be at the same location of the concentrated load, means at mid-span. Your value of moment will be 25 times 3 divide 6. Your value will be 37.5. The remaining part, this part. You have here three reaction, and you have here one concentrated load. This part looks like we have fixed support at these three reaction. We have concentrated load at this step. So you looks like this one. Fixed with cantilever and the concentrated load at the tip. So your bending moment diagram, if you remember, looks like triangle. and this value will be P time L. So P equal 12.5, L equal 3 meter. That means your bending moment on this part will be triangle, and this value will be P 12.5 time L 3 equal 37.5. So first step is very important. First step is very, very important. How to draw bending moment diagram using superposition. Superposition means I need to make my beam more simple. More simple. That means if you have beam connection, you have to do separation first. Once you do separation, you can see your beam parts looks like one of these parts. Probably concentrated load on simply supported, probably distributed load on simply supported, probably concentrated moment at one end, or probably cantilever with fixed from one side and distributed load. One of these guys, nothing else, nothing else. And these shapes will be given in your exam. Second step, we need to convert the real beam to conjugate beam. We need to convert the real beam, which is fixed, pin connection, and roller, to be conjugate beam. If you would like to convert this beam to conjugate beam, we need to follow the rules in this table. And this table also will be given in the exam. If you have pin, keep it at the end. If you have roller at the end, keep it. If you have fixed, make it free. If you have free, make it fixed. If you have hinge or roller, intermediate or internal, hinge or roller, make them to be pin connection. If you have pin connection, go ahead and make it roller. Let's start. I think we have fixed it. I will do it, or I will make it free. We have pin connection. I will make it roller. You have roller at the end or edge. That means keep it as it is. The new beam can be called conjugate beam. The new beam can be called conjugate beam. Very easy. Very easy. Just follow the rules in the table. So you can convert your beam to a new beam called conjugate beam. Then I will move this moment that you did in the first step on the new beam. So we have shapes looks like this. Exactly the same. 37.5, negative and positive. Very easy. Third step. Here is a beam. Here is a new support. Please pay attention. We have here triangle. The sign for this triangle is positive. The centroid for this triangle at mid-span. So at mid-span, we have concentrated load coming to up, pointing up. Why up? Because your diagram is positive. We have here another triangle, which is negative. And the centroid of this triangle looks like here, at 1/3 and 2/3. That means at this location, we have concentrated load going down. Why down? Because your diagram is negative. Why is this location at the centroid of this diagram? The value of this concentrated load equal area of this triangle, which is 1/2 times 6. 6 is the total distance. times 37.5. The area or the value of this concentrated load equals the area of this triangle. 1/2 times 3 times 37.5. Your value here will be, 0.5 times 6 times 37.5. This value will be 112.5. This value will be, I think, 1/2. 56.25. We have a new beam. We have a new load. That means we will have a new reaction. Can you go ahead and get the reactions or the new reaction at the new support? This support is called B, this support called D. So we have reaction here. I believe this reaction will be down. For my experience, I expect this reaction R at D will be down and this reaction will be up. Actually, you can assume what you want. Remember our rules at the beginning of this course. You can assume what you want. So I will assume this reaction up, R at D. How can I get these reactions? Go back to the first rule, summation F of Y, equilibrium equation equals zero. That means we have R, let's start from the beginning. We have negative 56.25. We have positive RB. We have positive 112.5. We have negative RD equals zero. We have two unknowns. I cannot do anything. Go ahead and take moment at any point. I recommend to take moment at D. Actually, you can take moment at any point. I will take moment at D equals zero, and I will assume this direction is positive. If you take moment at D, I will cancel RD, but we still have 112.5 times this little distance, which is three, and your direction will be positive. We have positive also RB times this horizontal distance, which is 6. We have negative, the remaining force, this one, 56.25. Anybody can tell me what is the distance between this force and the point D? Please write your comment. What is the distance? What do you think? 8. Perfect. Yes, we have here 2. We have here 6. So the total distance will be 8. Thank you. Equals 0. The only unknown in this equation is RB. I can figure out the reaction RB. Reaction RB will be 112.5 times 3 minus 56.25 times 8 divide 6. Your reaction will be positive. That means I did it correctly in the correct direction. 18.75. Then put this number here, 18.75. So I can figure out the reaction at D will be 75. So this reaction equal 75. This reaction equal 18.75. So just to remind you, what are the steps? First step, go ahead and draw bending moment diagram using superposition method, which means make your beam more simple. Then second step, convert your real beam to conjugate beam by following the rules in the table. And put the bending moment diagram on the new beam. Third step, we need to convert your bending moment diagram to load. If you have load, that means we need to figure out what are the reactions. So the third step, convert your bending moment diagram to something called elastic load, and then get your elastic reaction. Once you get your elastic reaction and elastic load, final step. Any theta equal shear. Any deflection equal moment. Any theta equal shear, any deflection equal moment. Theta, which is a slope or rotation, moment, which is deflection. Hey guys, don't forget, we are looking for rotation at A and D, which is theta A and theta D. We are looking for displacement, which is deflection, at B and the deflection at C. Okay, we are looking for theta A, theta D. Here is A, here is B, here is D. Anybody can tell me what is the shear at A? Do you have any concentrated load at A? Just to simplify this beam, here is the beam. We have here reaction down 75. We have here reaction up 18.75. We have here concentrated load, 112.5. We have here at this location, concentrated load 56.25. My question is, do you have any force at point A going up or going down, especially at point A? Do you have any force at A going up or going down to make shear? Do you have any force or any concentrated force at A going up or going down to make shear at A? Do you have? No, I'm talking about A on this diagram. The new beam, which is called the conjugate beam, under the effect of elastic load and the effect of elastic reaction. This case, in current situation, I'm not talking about the original beam. I'm not talking about the real beam. I'm talking about the new beam, which is called conjugate beam, under the effect of elastic load and under the effect of elastic reaction. Do you have any concentrated load at A going up or down? No. That means theta A equals zero. One more thing, theta at D, here is point D. Do you have any concentrated load going up or going down at point D? Yes, we have 75. And don't forget to divide this value or this reaction by EI to get your reaction, and your direction will be positive. Why positive? Just to remind you, for shear on this direction would like to be down to make this member to rotate clockwise. If you are talking about this side, must be up to make this member to rotate clockwise. So here is a positive direction of the shear force. So I think this side, under the effect of this concentrated load, would like to rotate this member clockwise, so this value will be positive. 75, why? Because the concentrated load at point D would like to make shear, so your value would be 75. divide it by EI to get the value of theta at D. So it is the first step. Free end means no concentrated load. That's right. No concentrated load, that means your theta is zero. So any theta is the concentrated load at this location. You are looking for theta at A. Okay, go ahead and search for any concentrated load at A. If you have, put it. If you don't have, your theta will be zero. For D, I'm looking for concentrated load. Do you have one? Yes, we have 75 divided by EI. I need to figure out, is it positive or negative based on the direction of this force? If this direction would like to make this member to rotate clockwise, it will be positive. Counterclockwise, it will be negative. Then we are looking for deflection at B and deflection at C. Just to remind you, here is the beam, the new beam. I'm talking about the new beam. We have roller. The original shape looks like this. I converted this moment to load. One concentrated load here. I recommend, but it will not make any difference in reaction. And one concentrated load here. I found this reaction and I found this reaction. This load 112.5. This one 56, I think, 25. This reaction was how much? 18.75. And this reaction, much 75. We are looking for deflection at point C. Here is point C. I'm sorry, B. Because this point is A, B, and this point is C, and this point is D. We are looking for deflection at point B. If you go back, deflection equal moment. I need to take moment at this location. Take moment at this location. So I will use the left part. Here is the left part. Here is your cut at B. We have concentrated load here, 56.25. At your cut, we have moment. Would like to make this member to smile. What is the value of this moment? Take moment at B. If you take moment at B equals zero, assume this direction is positive. That means we have M positive 56.25 times 2, because this distance is 2, equals zero. That means your value of moment will be 112.5. The value of moment at this location equal 112.5. Get this value, 112.5, divide EI, and here is your deflection at B. Positive means your point will move up. This point will move. Oh, I have a mistake here. M plus 56.25 times 2 equals 0. That means your moment will be negative. Your moment will be negative. Negative means this point will move down, not up. Why both of them the same sign? Because if you take moment here at this point, this moment rotate counterclockwise and this force counterclockwise also, so both of them will be positive. That means your moment will be negative. Negative 112.5 divide EI is the value of deflection at B. So this point will move down. Yes. I did cut at B to take to get a moment at this location. We are looking for a moment at B. Why moment? Because I'm looking for deflection. And the deflection in this method equal moment. So to get a moment, I did cut at B. Okay, I need to make another cut at C. Just to remind you for something very important. We have here a triangle. I recommend, if you would like to take moment at C, I need to get the force for this triangle alone and this triangle alone. Why? Do you know why? Because if you did cut here and take the right part, you have the whole triangle or half the triangle. I think we have the triangle. So we have reaction here, down 75. We have this part of triangle with equivalent force will be 56.25, and I'm taking a moment at C. This one is confused a little bit, but if you would like from the beginning, to divide this triangle to two triangles, this one alone with equivalent force and this one alone with equivalent force, that will be better if you would like, because it will not make any difference if you take the whole triangle as one triangle or divide this triangle to two triangles. Will not make any difference, only for this point C. So at point C, I have a moment. If you take moment at C equal zero, assume this direction is positive. So we have M, we have positive 75 times three, we have negative 56.25 times one. Remember, this whole distance is three. This little distance will be one third. This distance will be 2/3. Equal zero. The only unknown in this equation is the moment at point C. This value of moment will be 75 times 3 minus 56.25 times 1. Your value will be negative 168.75. That means deflection at point C will be this moment, which is negative, divide ER. Your value of deflection is negative. That means this point moved down. So, last step in this method, we need to figure out what is the value of theta, what is the value of deflection. Value of theta is the value of shear. Do you have concentrated load? Yes, this concentrated load will be the value of theta. If you don't have, will be zero. Deflection at any point will be the moment at this point. Let me do one more example. We have a beam, a hinge at B, roller at D, we have concentrated load 10 kilonewton at C and the concentrated load 5 kilonewton at A. We are looking for rotation at A and B, theta A, theta B. We are looking for displacement at B, deflection at, I'm sorry, at A. We don't care about what's required. We have some steps for conjugate beam method. Remind me, first step in this method, we need to draw bending moment diagram using sober position method. My question is, do you have pin connection in this beam right now? Do you have pin connection? No, we don't have pin connection. So this beam is very, very simple. This beam will be very, very simple. That means I will go ahead directly to draw bending moment diagram. I think this beam for this part from D to B looks like this. We have hinge, we have roller, and we have concentrated load here, 10 kilonewton. So this shape will give you triangle of moment. This value, which is at the location of the load, equal P A B divided N. So I think the first shape of the moment will be triangle on this part. And this value will be 10 times 5 times 5 divided 10 equals 25. Then I think the remaining part, hey guys, if you put this one, it doesn't, I don't care about it, nothing on it. The second case, for the second scenario, I'm going to assume I have this concentrated load on. So what do you think? I believe this part looks like cantilever with fixed here and the concentrated load here. So I think your bending moment diagram on this part looks like this. PL, P, this distance is L. So I think you have a moment here. P is 5, L is 1 meter. Your value would be 5. What will happen for the remaining part? I will connect this value to 0. So the bending moment diagram on this beam due to the concentrated load 5 kilonewton looks like triangle in this shape. And this value would be 5, and this diagram would be negative, and this diagram would be positive. Hey guys, let's go back to these diagrams. If you have concentrated load between hinge and the roller, your moment will be triangle. If you have concentrated load at the tip of a cantilever, your moment will be looks like triangle. That means if you have simply supported beam with nothing and the cantilever and your concentrated load at the tip, your bending moment diagram on the cantilever part will look like this one. And this value will be PL. Then the remaining part, I will connect it to 0. This is what happened here. This case, we don't have pin connection. So we are good. Go ahead and draw your bending moment diagram. I'm going to assume my beam with this concentrated load only. So I have concentrated wood between hinge and roller. Your moment looks like triangle. This value PAB over L. Then I'm going to assume my beam with this concentrated load only. So it looks like this concentrated load at the tip of a cantilever. So this part looks like this one. We have a triangle and this value PL. The remaining part of the beam looks like I will connect to zero. Once you have both of them at the same time, that means we have the both diagrams at the same time. Any question for this point? This method called superposition method. It's a special method. Superposition method. We need to draw bending moment diagram with shapes that I can figure out the area, centroid, all of this stuff. Okay. This is the first step. And I believe if you did this step correctly, I think you will get 80 or 90% of this problem. Because this step is very important. How to draw bending moment diagram using superposition. Okay, what is the next step? Next step, we need to convert this real beam to conjugate beam. We need to convert this real beam to conjugate beam. Please go back to the table. If you have three, I will make it fixed. If you have roller, internal roller, I will convert it to be pin connection. If you have hinge or roller at the edge, keep it as it is. Very simple. This method or this step is very easy. Just we need to convert the real beam to a conjugate beam using the rules in the table. If you have three end in the real beam, make it fixed in the conjugate beam. If you have internal hinge or roller, make it pin connection. If you have hinge or roller at the edge of the beam, leave it as it is. Then I will redraw my bending moment diagram on this new beam. This value is 2.5. This diagram is positive. We have triangle here. And we have another triangle here. This one is negative, this one is negative, and this value is 5. What do you think? Third step. So first step, draw. Second step, conjugate beam. Convert your real beam to a conjugate beam. Third step, we have load. And we have reaction. What do you mean? I mean, here is the beam, the new beam. I'm talking about the new beam. We have here pin connection. We have here fixed. So I have here a concentrated load up coming from this triangle. This triangle is positive. So this concentrated load will be up at the centroid of this concentrated load. How much? 1/2 times 10 times 25, the area of this triangle. The total distance is 10 this height is 5. So the area will be 1 half times 10 times 25 equal 125. Also, I will have concentrated load down. Coming from what? This triangle only. This triangle is negative. Your concentrated load will be down. The centroid of this triangle will be here. So the location of this force will be here. At 1/3. This distance is 1/3 L, but this distance is 1/2. Because this equilateral triangle, but this one is right angle triangle. How much for this one? 1/2 times 10 times this value, which is 5. Your value will be 25. And we have another triangle here with concentrated load down. Why down? Because this triangle is negative. At which location? At the centroid of this triangle, it's 1/3 and 2/3. How much? 1/2 times 1 times 5. Your value will be 2.5. So finally, we have a beam fixed in connection, concentrated support here, hinge. We have concentrated load here at mid span. 125. We have concentrated load here at 1/3 and 2/3, 25. We have concentrated load here, 2.5. So I converted my bending moment diagram to elastic load. I need to figure out the elastic reaction. We have hinge, we have fixed, so we have reaction. I think we have reaction here at this hinge. Probably this reaction will be down. I'm not sure, but anyway, this point is A, E, E, I think. No. C, this point is C, and this point is D. We have reaction here at B. We will have three reaction at A, RA, and horizontal reaction and moment. Actually, if you go back to chapter 2, I would like to calculate reaction, but we have right now in this situation, we have pin connection. So I need to do separation first to be able to calculate for reaction. So I will do this part alone and this part alone. I have reaction here, RB. I have three reaction here, RA, XA, and MA. And at this pin connection, we have horizontal reaction and vertical reaction. Probably the vertical reaction would be like this. Yes. And we have horizontal reaction here and vertical reaction, same values but in opposite direction. Don't forget, we have concentrated load here, 125. We have concentrated load here, 25. We have concentrated load here, 2.5. Go ahead and apply summation f of x equals 0. This reaction will be 0. Summation f of y equals 0. Summation moment at any point equals 0. I can figure out these reactions. These reactions will be 125. This reaction RB will be 54.16 divided by 16, and the other reaction 45.8 divide ER. I'm sorry, not divide anything. This reaction will be the same value, but in opposite direction, 45.8. If you apply here summation F of X equals zero, and this reaction will be zero. This XA will be zero. If you apply summation F of Y equals zero, summation moment at any point equals zero, I can figure out these reactions. So this reaction will be down, not up, will be down. How much? Minus 2.5. 43.33. This moment will be 2.5 minus 45.8 times 1. This moment will be 44.55, will be in opposite direction, this direction, the correct direction. So finally, I can figure out the elastic reaction after you converted your moment to elastic loop. Theta will be shear. We are looking for theta at what? A and B. A and B. Where is A? Where is point A? I think point A is here. Point B is there. And the point D is here. Anybody can tell me what is the shear force at point A? Do you have any concentrated load at this point? Yes. We have reaction RA equal 43.33. So your shear or your theta at this location equal 43.33 divide EI, and it will be negative. Remember, your shear would like to make your member to rotate clockwise. I think your reaction at this location is down, 43.33. This direction is opposite to the positive direction. So this value of shear will be negative value. Theta at B. Do you have any concentrated load at point B, and this concentrated load will make shear? Yes, we have R at B. If you don't have, your value is zero. But we have 54.16. I think this direction matching with this direction, that means we have positive 54.16 divide ER. So your theta at A and B can be done. We are looking for deflection at A. Just to remind you guys, deflection equal what? Theta equal shear, but deflection equal moment. So Y equal moment. We are looking for deflection at A. Do you have a moment at A? Yes, we have concentrated moment at this location equal 44.55 divide EI, and the positive direction of this moment would like to make this member to smile, so it will be positive. Positive means this point moved up. That's it. I am done. So your problem has many steps. I would like to share my thought about this problem. First step, you need to draw bending moment diagram using superposition method. Second step, you need to convert your real beam to a conjugate beam. using the rules in the table. Third step, you need to convert this bending moment diagram to elastic loop and figure out the elastic reaction. Once you get your elastic reaction, 90% of the score is done. The remaining 10%, your theta is a shear. Do you have concentrated to this? This is the value of shear. No, your shear is zero. Y is a moment. So go ahead and get a moment. If you have concentrated moment like this one, it will be your deflection. If you don't have, go ahead and make cut and get your moment like we did in the previous problem. Okay, go ahead, Brock. What do you have? What is your question? How is it? How is theta B positive? What is theta B? Yeah, okay. Theta B. Let me explain it here. Here is the beam. The positive sign for shear, this shear and this shear would like to make this member to rotate clockwise. This is the positive direction, and this is the positive direction. Go ahead and matching between this end and this end. Both of them in the same direction. Yes, this one is down, and this one is down, so this reaction will be positive. But for this one, for the other one, at A. Here is the positive sign. Here is the beam. Positive sign would like to rotate this member to a clockwise direction. I have question. Can you match between this direction and this direction? This is a positive direction. So I think this reaction, which is down, opposite to this direction, which is positive, so this reaction would be negative. So theta at A is negative, but theta at B is positive. So keep in your mind that the direction of the positive direction of shear, like this, and the positive direction of moment to make your members to smile. If you have something opposite to this direction, it will be negative. The same direction will be positive. Okay, you can, okay. Positive direction on the right side is down. Okay. I don't like to remember these rules in this way. I like to remember the rules by diagrams. My positive shear looks like this. You need to match the direction. If you are talking about your beam from this side, you need to look to this side. If you are talking about the beam on this side, you need to look to this side. Okay? Before finishing up this meeting today, I would like to talk a little bit about your homework to help you something. Let's see. I think the first problem in the homework to start to draw your bending moment diagram. Actually, we don't have any mini load. First of all, we don't have pin connection. So go ahead and draw your bending moment diagram directly with superposition. How many loads do you have? We have only one at the tip of the cantilever. So I believe your moment on this part will be triangle. Looks like this. How much? P times L. So will be 15 times 15. 15 is the load. 15 is the distance. And then the remaining part of the simple supported beam, I will connect it to zero. This is a bending moment diagram using superposition method. Second step, I need to convert this beam to conjugate beam, this real beam to conjugate beam. So your new beam looks like this. We have hinge at the end will be the same. We have internal roller, it will be pin connection. We have free end, it will be fixed. Then go ahead and put the bending moment diagram that you are done in the first step on the conjugate beam. So I believe we have concentrated, this one is negative, this one is negative. We have concentrated dude coming down here from this triangle. We have another concentrated dude coming here. But before starting to get your elastic reaction, we need to do separation because we have pin connection. So go ahead and do separation. We have this part alone, fix it, and this part alone with hinge. We have concentrated dude here, and we have concentrated dude here. This concentrated dude down because your diagram is negative. Add the centroid of this triangle. And don't forget we have three reaction at this fixet. We have two reaction at this hinge. And we have at this pin connection two reaction, one vertical and one horizontal. Will be the same here, but in opposite direction. Once you get your elastic reaction, go ahead and figure out what is the required. We are looking for slope and the deflection at C. So we are looking for theta C, Y C. By the way, theta at C will be this reaction. Y at C will be this moment. That's it. This for the first one. For the second one, we need to draw bending moment diagram. Actually, I cannot start to draw bending moment diagram unless you do separation because we have pin connection. So please, at any moment, if you have pin connection, you have to do separation first. If you have pin connection, you have to do separation first. So I believe I will do separation here. This one is roller. We have concentrated dude here, six skip. And here is the remaining part. We have fixed. You will have vertical reaction here will be down. How much this reaction? It could be six also. And this reaction will be 12. And this reaction horizontal will be zero. This one will be zero. This one will be six. So, your bending moment diagram for this part will be like this. Can you see here? This part looks like a beam with support here hinge because we have two reactions. And we have roller and you have concentrated with here six. Your bending moment diagram on this part will be like this. Here is the moment. E, L, and the remaining part of the beam will be connected to zero. So this value will be 6 times 12. I think it will be 72. Then, this part of the beam, fixed, and your concentrated dude coming from down. Can you tell me how can I draw the triangle? Go back to your notes. Go back here, yes. I told you if your concentrated load coming from up to down like this, your triangle will be negative. But right now we have a different situation. Your concentrated load is coming from down to up. So your triangle will be positive. PL. Hey guys, this one is very important. I covered this situation, but right now we have a different situation. What we covered before, if your concentrated load coming from up to down, your triangle looks like this, negative, PL. But right now your concentrated load coming from down to up, from down to up, so your triangle looks like this, PL. Anybody know why? 5 point. Do you know why this triangle is down? If the concentrated load coming to down and this triangle is up positive, if your concentrated load goes up, 5 point. Any answer? Go ahead and talk if you can. Guys, a question one more time. Do you know why your triangle is positive if the concentrated load coming down? I'm sorry, as a triangle is negative if the concentrated load coming down, and why this triangle is positive if the concentrated load goes up? Do you have a reason for that? Anybody? No response? Guys, are you here? Are you still here? Okay, so no answer? Yeah, I see something here. No. Not counterclockwise. I hate this direction. There is something else. Alex, do you have a response? No, this is not the reason. To smile. Okay. Guys, because we don't have enough time, by the way, yes, your triangle here will be positive, and this value will be 72 also. Then second step, go ahead and convert this beam to conjugate beam. Guys, E time L. Anybody can tell me how can this P rotate around this fixed? I think P times L would like to rotate this member like this. In the second case, your concentrated load P times L would like to rotate this member like this. This one is coming down. So rotation will be like this. This one going up, so the rotation will be like this. Last time, and also before last time, I told you the bending moment follow the head of the arrow. Where is the head of this direction is down, your moment will be down. Where is the head of this direction is up, your moment will be up. So keep in your mind all the time that if you have concentrated moment or direction of moment, your diagram will follow the head of the arrow. If your head is up, your diagram will be up. If your head is down, your diagram will be down. So right now, I almost solved the two remaining problems, and also I covered this problem. So go ahead and finish up your homework number 7. The due date will be next Tuesday.